guys. Welcome to the first official installment of Dear Fat Girl. The response was overwhelming. You guys sent so many emails. And real quick, since in the last video I didn't have the email address yet, if you have a topic or a question or anything that you want answered, go ahead and email me at asksarahvargas@gmail.com and I will try to include it in a video or help you out some way. So you can email all of your suggestions or stories or anything, whether it be for Dear Fat Girl or Let's Talk About Sex or just general, at asksarahvargas@gmail.com, and I'll write it below in case you don't know how to spell my name. And that leads me to my intro. Hello guys, I'm Sarah Ray Vargas. I read every single email, and there were hundreds and hundreds of them, and I just spent like the last hour reading all of the emails and all of you guys' stories, and I really appreciate that you guys take the time out to share your stories with me and to be so nice. So many of you guys are just like, you lead in your email, it just starts with like, just, I love you for 12 million different reasons, and then you list them all, and I'm like, oh my God, like, you make me so happy to read these emails. So first of all, thank you guys to those of you that sent in your emails and just the constant love that you shower me with on YouTube and Instagram, Twitter, and everywhere else. But I was trying to pick out which topic to sort of go with initially. And of course, there are always recurring themes in your guys' emails because a lot of us are dealing sort of with the same issues. And I thought that the best way to start this series would be to just talk about the core issue that it seems everyone is dealing with. And that would be just confidence, period. Not feeling like you're good enough for someone or yourself or anything. So a lot of you have problems with feeling confident, which hands down, that is my most asked question ever. Anytime I post a Q&A on Instagram or YouTube or anything else, you guys always ask me, either how did you get to be so confident, or how can I be confident, or how did you get over body issues, how did you gain a better self-image and have more self-esteem? Unfortunately, it's not something that you can just answer. I can't just tell you, you know, here's steps XYZ, and there you go. Once you do that, you are gonna be confident and loving life and da 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 da. Like, that's not how it works. Okay, to be honest, you guys, I got kind of upset reading the emails. Not necessarily you guys were not being mean or anything, but it just took me back, which these sorts of emails always sort of take me back to when I felt not so good about myself. It takes me back and it makes me sad. It doesn't make me sad because of who I am now. It makes me sad because I know exactly how it feels to be in these situations and to feel so crappy about yourself. And it makes me sad because so many of you are going through it still. And so this video is kind of just to tell you guys that I don't want you to feel that way. And some of the ways that I have sort of gained confidence in myself, and really the biggest thing that I've done in the last year, is when I have become most confident and most accepting of myself and proud of myself and happy in my body and happy in my mind, is just being around positivity. And I don't necessarily mean the people that I'm around, although I am in a good environment. My family, my friends are good people, and I do make sure to surround myself with people that I like and people that I think, you know, are appreciative of me, and I'm appreciative of them. And I, you know, I run into people that I don't necessarily like. I try to jive with a lot of different people because I try to make connections. I'm in a world where you have to be social for this particular career. And when I don't get along with someone, I don't get along with someone, and I take that person out of my life as much as I possibly can. But YouTube has been a huge motivational factor for me. Like, it's been such a nice addition to my life. There is a lot of hate, but there is so much more love. And one of the things that has showed me that, Sarah, you should be confident and you should feel good about yourself and you are worthy and intelligent and beautiful, is having you guys tell me that and having you guys affirm those things for me. And what I'm trying to do, because I don't suggest that you all go out and get YouTube channels and post videos of yourself, because they're, you know, YouTube is, people are mean. Okay, people are really mean sometimes. And if you have a crappy self-image and you are insecure, putting yourself out on YouTube, not the way to go. People are going to rip you apart and nobody likes that. So I do suggest though that you let yourself be exposed to things that are going to make you feel better. So watch body confidence videos. Don't watch the videos about stupid little boys telling you that if you're fat, then you're gonna be, no one's gonna like you, no one's gonna love you, da 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 da. Like, don't watch shit like that. Don't expose yourself to media that is constantly perpetuating a horrible, horrible, horrible societal norm of only skinny people, very skinny people, no cellulite, no stretch marks, no imperfections, period. Only those people are worthy, and only those people are the people that you should be looking up to in life. So don't read dumb magazines like OK Magazine and Star Magazine, and most magazines, don't read these magazines because they only show you things that are perfect. They only show you people that are Photoshop to perfection. Don't watch these TV shows that do the same exact thing. Just don't allow yourself to constantly consume that media. And I know sometimes you can't totally avoid it, but for the most part, be intentional about what you are allowing yourself to be exposed to. And this is not because I think that you should not, you know, that you want to live in like a fairy tale world, but the fact is that magazines like that, movies, TV shows, idiots on YouTube, like, that's stuff is not necessarily what's right, it's just what's normal. It's just what our society has deemed normal. And so be really, really aware of what you are consuming. So if you enjoy my body positivity videos, or other people's videos like this, then I suggest that you just focus on consuming this type of media more. I don't just mean watch all my videos, I mean like be sure that you are following people that make you feel good. Okay, follow bloggers that make you feel good. If you're into fashion, follow body positive fashion bloggers. There are a ton of them, and I am friends with a ton of them. And I can tell you that seeing them rock their freaking outfits, like, that makes me feel so good sometimes, because I'm like, oh, damn, girl, I know you had it like that. Like, I can get it like that too. So stuff like that makes me feel good. And exposing myself to this type of media has made me feel much better about myself, because the plus size community has really been growing. And I don't mean we've been growing like our bodies. I mean the community of people, the amount of people that are being positive, that are contributing positive content, whether it be blog posts or videos or just fashion or anything, like whatever it is, books, anything. There's just so much of it now that I can spend my days when I am choosing to consume any type of media, I can spend it consuming only positive media that makes me feel good about myself. It doesn't tell me that being fat is healthy. It tells me that being myself is perfectly fine, and it's something that I should be happy about, and I should know my worth, and I should know that I'm beautiful. And this is the same message that I want you guys to consume on a regular basis. This is what I want you to believe, because it is true, because you are a worthy person, because you are a beautiful person. Beauty is so subjective, okay? Beauty, you've heard this before, right? Beauty is in the eye of the beholder. That could not be more true. There are just so many people in the world, we cannot all agree on anything. We can't all agree that so-and-so is good-looking and so-and-so is attractive and we all like so-and-so. Like, we can't agree on that. So don't try to make your life about having everyone think that, oh, she's so pretty, or she's so this, or she's so smart, blah, blah, blah. Like, just focus on you believing these things and you perpetuating these things, okay? Believe in yourself. Believe that you're beautiful. Believe that you're worthy, because you are. Because you are all of these things. Just know that the only constant in your life, for your entire life, the only thing that without a doubt is going to be a part of you for your whole life is you. You are the only constant in your entire life. You'd think, oh, well, I'm gonna have my parents or my kids or my boyfriend or my this or my this or my this. You're not. You're not gonna have your looks forever. You're not gonna have your body the way that it is forever, whether you like it now or you don't. You're not always gonna have the people that are in your life. People die, people move, people change, people move on. Things happen, everything changes. The only thing that's always gonna be a part of your life is you. And so you need to focus on making your love of yourself. Like, you need to focus on loving yourself. You need to focus on feeling good about yourself. You need to focus on the positive things that you see in yourself, and focus more on harnessing these new things and growing and becoming stronger. And I don't mean necessarily physically stronger, but find the strength within yourself to move past negativity, to see good things in yourself, and to show other people these good things. You don't need to hide behind anything. If you're fat, you don't need to feel bad about it. You don't need to feel like There's so many worse things in this world than being fat. So many worse things than being fat. If your biggest problem is that you're fat, honey, you got a good life, okay? And it may not feel that way all the time, but if your biggest issue is your weight, you have a good life, and appreciate that. And I know that our weight, especially when it's constantly staring us in the face and it's something that we carry around all day, literally, figuratively, you know, it's something that we are carrying with us. I know that it can feel like a huge burden and it can feel like a huge issue and it can make us feel bad, but I just want you to try to not let that be what determines how you feel day to day. Don't let the number on the scale be what makes you happy or sad in a day-to-day basis. Another thing that I would really like to address is that most of the emails that you guys sent me, while I do appreciate them, many of them, most of them actually, had to do with you and a guy, whether it be a guy that you're dating or a guy that you'd like to date, maybe a guy that you're married to or a situation you had with a guy. And I understand that relationships and boyfriends and things of this nature are really important and they can have a big impact on your life. That's all cool. I totally understand that. I mean, I have a Let's Talk About Sex series, right? So obviously I think that relations are important and it is something that I take my time out to talk about and to educate about. So I completely, you know, I understand why you guys write to me about these things, but the parts of these emails that I found to be incredibly problematic are that you guys are determining your worth on whether or not a guy likes you. So I know that as women, we have sort of been raised to really value what men think of us. And this is something that we have to break out of, and it's hard, and it's taken me a long time, and it's still something I'm working on. But we've been sort of raised to value that. So if a guy likes you, that's great, you're doing good. Maybe he's gonna wanna marry you. Maybe he'll pop the question, right? You know, eventually. we're too concerned with it though. I think we've been raised to value what men have to say about us and what men think of us. Like, you know, should I wear this dress? Are the guys gonna like it? Should I wear my hair like this? Is so-and-so gonna like it? Like, we've been raised to think this way and it's ridiculous. It's horrible and it's the society that we live in. But I urge you, as a woman, as a girl, however old you are, I urge you to not let what a man thinks of you, what a boy thinks of you, what any person thinks of you affect what you think of yourself. I used to only feel good when a guy liked me and when a guy was showing me attention, because that made me feel like my body's okay, my life is okay, as long as a man likes me and loves me or wants to be with me, then everything in my life is right. And I want you guys to know that that's not exactly true, okay? and I want you to realize that men do not determine their worth and how well they're doing in life. Like, those factors in their life are not predicated on whether or not a woman likes them, a girl likes them, they're in a relationship. Like, that's not how men go through life. That's how women go through life. And so please stop. Stop doing that. Let me tell you this. I am 26. I just turned 26. And I can tell you that right now is the happiest I've ever been. It's the most confident I've ever been. I am more determined and I have more ambition than I've ever had in my life. And I am getting things done. I am accomplishing my goals, and I have been for about the last 15 months or so, right? Now, I have plenty of men that would love to date me. And I get constant streams of, you know, I get nasty emails and the regular dick pics from dicks, okay? But I also get men that are desirable for a variety of reasons. I have them approach me and they want to date me or they want to get to know me or whatever. And I can tell you something, it's not because of the way that I look, although they are physically and sexually attracted to me and they've told me this, you know, you have a beautiful face and hair and I love your body and da da da. They are very, very, very attracted to my intelligence. They're attracted to my honesty. They're attracted to my ambition, to my ability. They're attracted to all of these other things that have nothing to do with how much I weigh. They are attracted to my confidence. I'm not only confident as a fat girl, I am confident as a woman. I'm confident, period. So my point is that you can be fat and worthy and beautiful and a great person and intelligent and going places. You can be a great mom, you can be a great girlfriend and wife, but you can be a great woman, period, and be fat. Being fat does not stop you from being anything other than thin, basically. That is the only thing that you can't be when you're fat. You can't be thin and fat, but you can be whatever the hell else you want to be. And you are beautiful and you are worthy and you do not need to look down on yourself because of how you look. And you don't need to base your value on whether or not a guy likes you or how another guy feels about you. You don't need to base how you feel about yourself on how other people feel about you. So I think that's where I'm going to end it. And I hope that you guys enjoyed this first installment of Dear Fat Girl. I know there are going to be many, many, many more to come. Thank you again for the people that emailed me, and thank you to the people that are going to email me. I hope that you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, be sure to share it and like it and spread the word for anyone else that may be struggling with their body issues. Just know that you are not alone. Many of us are dealing with the same issues. So many of you guys are dealing with the same issues and you feel really alone, and I think it's because you don't have anyone right next to you going through the same thing. But just know that you're not alone, and don't forget to subscribe. I will see you in my next video, and don't forget, dear fat girl, you're beautiful.
Hello, my only one. Remember who you are. No, you're not perfect, but you're not your mistakes. Hey, 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 hey. Oh, the good outweighs the bad, even though you're